How are you all? I hope you all are fine and safe at home. Okay, students, in your previous class, you learned many concepts like big or small, short or long, heavy or light, tall or short, more or less. Right? Okay, and another most important is positions. Another most important is position. Like inside and outside, top and bottom, far and near, on and under, above and below. Okay. So let us start our very first topic. It is inside and outside. What is our first topic? It is inside and outside. Shall we write? Okay, listen. Inside and outside. I N S I D E. Inside and outside. O U C S I D E. Outside. What is our first answer? It is inside and outside. What is the meaning of inside? Any idea? Okay, let's clear it. Listen, inside means which is in something or which is covered with something. Inside means which is in something or which is covered with something. Okay, then for example, mango. Look here, what is this? Mango. Okay, when your mother cuts mango, where did you find the seed? Where did you find the seed? Any idea? Some of them are seen. Where it is? Inside the fruit. Where is the seed? Inside the fruit. Okay. Which means the seed is covered with the fruit. Which means the seed is covered with the fruit. As you can easily see in the picture, the seed is covered with the fruit. Isn't it? The seed is covered with the fruit. So it means something which is covered with the particular object is called inside. So it means something which is covered with the particular object is called inside. Okay, do you understand? Okay, then let us talk about outside. Let us talk about outside. What do you mean by outside? Any idea? Then let's clear it. Outside means which is out something or which is outside of a particular thing. Outside means which is out something or which is outside of a particular thing. Okay. Let us move on the example. Let us move on the example. Look here. What is this? It is cashew nuts. It is cashew nuts. Cashew nuts grows outside the fruit, isn't it? Cashew nuts grows outside the fruit. It is the dry fruit. It is the dry fruit. The seed of cashew nut is not inside. It is very clear in the picture. The seed of cashew nut not inside the fruit. It is outside the fruit. Okay. Now, we can easily differentiate between inside and outside. Now, we can easily differentiate inside and outside. Here, cashew nut seed grows outside the fruit, whereas the mango seed grows inside the fruit. Here, cashew nut seed grows outside the fruit, whereas the mango seed grows inside the fruit. Okay, we can look another few examples. Look the picture. It is papaya seed and strawberry seed. It is papaya seed and strawberry seed. Papaya seed, which you can see in the picture, that is black in color. Which color? Black in color. The seeds are covered with the fruit seeds are covered with the fruit are inside the fruit. Where it is? Inside the fruit. And whereas in the strawberry seeds are outside. The seeds are outside. Okay. Do you understand? Okay. Another example, I would like to take games. Do you like games? Yes, I know you like games. That is why I chose games. Okay. Look this picture. What is this? Yes, it is football. It is football. Football is a kind of game we play outside our home. Where we play? Outside our home. Because it needs more place. It needs more place. Whereas, if we talk about the games like carrots and chess, where we play this, like these games? Yes, we play inside our home. Where we play? Inside our home. Okay, in the next picture, look here. In first picture, you can see the dog is sitting inside the kennel. Where is dog sitting? Inside the kennel. Okay, and second picture shows us the dog is sitting outside the kennel. Where is dog sitting? Outside the kennel. Okay, do you understand? What is our first concept? It is inside and outside. It is inside and outside. Okay, what is spelling of inside? INSIDE. Okay, the next one is outside. 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 Okay. So, from this example, the concept of inside and outside is very much clear. Right? Then let us start our very next concept. It is top and bottom. So let us start our very next concept. It is top and bottom. Top and bottom. Okay, shall we write? T O P. Top and bottom. T-O-M. Top and bottom. Our next concept is top and bottom. Okay. What do you mean by top? What do you mean by top? Any idea?
Means the position where something is placed above the ground. Top means the position where something is placed above the ground. Above the ground. Ground means floor, land, like that. We all stand on the floor or something above, right? Something above. Okay. Then next one is bottom. What is next one? Bottom. Bottom means something which is kept below. Bottom means something which is kept below. Okay, something which is kept below means something which is kept above. Bottom means something which is kept below. Okay, do you understand? Let's move on the example. Let us move on the example. Look at the picture. There are four books in the pile. How many books are there? Four books. Okay. What is the meaning of pile? What is the meaning of pile? One book on the top of others is called pile of books or collection of books. Okay. And in this picture there are four books. Okay. In this picture how many books are? Four books. Can you tell me the position of blue book? Can you? Yes, some of them are saying the blue book is kept on the top of the pile. The blue book is kept on on the top of the pile. It is on the first position. It is on the first position. Now, if you see the position of red book, that is placed the bottom of the pile. That is the bottom of the pile because it is the last book among the pile. It is the last book among the pile. You can see three books on top of it. How many books? Three books on the top of it. So red book is placed bottom of the pile, whereas blue book is placed top of the pile. Red book is placed bottom of the pile, whereas blue book is placed top of the pile. Did you understand? Okay, then shall we move on the next example? Look this picture. There are two boys playing on a different slide. There are two boys playing on a different slide. You can see two pictures. You can see two pictures. First and second one. In this picture, first boy is on the bottom of the slide. First boy is on the bottom. First boy is on the bottom of the slide. Why? Because his position is toward down. His position is toward down. That is why his position on the bottom. Okay. And in the second picture, second one is on the top of the slide. Top of the slide. That placed on the top of the slide. So, first picture tells us he is on the bottom of the slide. So, first picture tells us he is on the bottom of the slide. And second picture tells us he is on the top of the slide. Isn't it? Okay. Shall we move on to the next example? Look the picture. The boy is confused. Why he is confused? Why? Because he is having three items and one bag. He is having three items and one bag. He is confused that which item he should get on the top of the position. I help you to solve it. Very good. Let's see. So, the items are eggs, coconuts and onions. Three items are there, right? Eggs, coconuts and onions. So which item he should cut at the bottom of the bag? Which item he should cut at the bottom of the bag? Can you tell? Which item he will keep at the bottom of the bag? Some of them are saying he will keep coconuts at the bottom of the bag. He will keep coconuts at the bottom of the bag. Why? Why? Because coconut is very heavy and hard, right? Coconut is very heavy and hard. That is why he will keep coconuts at the bottom of the bag. Okay, that is why he will keep coconuts at the bottom of the bag. And second level, he will keep onions. Second level, he will keep onions. At the last, he will keep eggs. That means that will not break. Okay, do you understand? That will not break.
Inside and outside, top and bottom. Okay, inside and
INSIDE. Okay, how do you spell outside? OUTSIDE. Okay, inside and outside. Our first concept is inside and outside. And second one, top and bottom. How do you spell top? T-O-P. Top. Now, how do you spell bottom? B-O-T-T-O-M. Okay, the students, there is a homework for you. Do your lecture activities, page number 6 and 7. This is your homework, page number 6 and 7. There are some questions, I will read. Color the fruits that are outside the basket. Color the fruit that are outside the basket. We learn outside and inside, right? So you can do this activity. Next one, color the legs that are inside the pond. Inside the pond. Okay, next one, top and bottom. Draw a bird on the top of the tree. Draw a bird on the top of the tree. Second, circle the child at the bottom of the slide. Bottom of the slide. Thus, you should study the concept. Okay, then study the spelling also.